So one extremely important operation in analyzing social networks is finding the shortest path between individuals in the graph. Not generally because we need the actual path, but because we want to have some sense of how closely connected different pieces of the graph are. But the pairwise shortest path problem is of independent interest. It's actually kind of fun and interesting to see. Essentially, what allows Google Maps or MapQuest or Yahoo Maps to plot shortest paths for you to drive. But another kind of whimsical version of this problem is the Kevin Bacon game. And Kevin Bacon is an actor. He's been in a lot of movies. And for some strange reason, he's been in lots of different movies with lots of different kinds of people. And so it turns out to be interesting and not always very difficult to connect Kevin Bacon to any actor you want. So imagine the problem goes like this. I'm going to give you a graph, G, and some node in the graph, V1, call it Kevin Bacon, and some other node in the graph, let's say Emma Watson, and we're going to try to find the shortest path between them. In the movie version, the graph consists of the actors connected to each other if they were in a movie together. Now, Kevin Bacon and Emma Watson have not been in any movies together, but there is a short path between them. Now, we haven't designed an algorithm to do this yet, but fortunately, there is a source on the internet, because there's always a source on the internet, that will help us with this kind of problem. There is a website called The Oracle of Bacon. There's Kevin Bacon now. And what it allows you to do is solve exactly this problem on the graph of movie actors and movies that they've appeared in. It defaults to Kevin Bacon, but you can actually put in anything you want here. But we're going to leave it as Kevin Bacon for the moment and ask it to find a connection to Emma Watson. You can see that I tried this in advance. And we look for a link, and bang, it found one. It turns out that Emma Watson from the Harry Potter movies was in Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2, 2011. And John Hurt was one of the actors in that movie. Well, it turns out John Hurt was actually in a movie with Kevin Bacon, or is about to be, called Jane Mansfield's Car. This isn't possibly the most interesting chain, but one of the things that really is interesting is very hard, at least it was very hard for me, to find actors that are more than two steps away from Kevin Bacon. So I tried kind of recent people who you wouldn't think would be in movies with Kevin Bacon, and you find out that they're pretty closely connected. I tried really, much older people, like Cary Grant. He is also two steps away via Walter Matthau. So it's just crazy. I mean, people back from silent movies, back in the very beginning of movies being made, are two steps away from Kevin Bacon through people I haven't heard of. So there's something special about the position that Kevin Bacon occupies in this graph. We can find other people. Let's connect Charlie Chaplin and Justin Bieber. We'll see that ends up being more than two links, at least I expect. Three, four, three. So Charlie Chaplin, Marjorie Bennett, to Fred Willard, to Justin Bieber. One, two, three links. So the movie could be that the movie graph is just not really all that wide, at least among the people that are reasonably well known. But that gives you a feel for the way that the problem works. Now let's talk about how we can actually solve this algorithmically.